السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله، الحمد لله الذي علم بالقلم، علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، فيا أيها الإخوان، أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله، واتقوا الله حق تقاته، واعلموا أن الله مع المتقين. إتلى المسلمين تقوى الله. إتلى
giác ngộ và kính sợ đến ông con chân thật tình. Vì những gì mà chúng ta đang sống, đang nghe và đang thấy, ngày tháng trôi qua, năm cũ vừa bước qua thì năm mới lại đến. Thời gian đã đi qua cuộc đời của chúng ta mà chúng ta vẫn vô tư xem như không có gì xảy đến. Hỡi con cháu của Nabi Adam Alayhissalam, dù cho chúng ta có sống đến 100 năm nữa hoặc hơn thế nữa, thì phải biết rằng rồi sẽ có một ngày nào đó chúng ta phải xuôi tay lặng lẽ và ra đi với mình. Nếu có ai nói rằng tôi chờ đến 50-60 tuổi thì tôi mới an tâm mà hành đạo, hàng hồi số mệnh con người không biết còn sống đến giờ phút nào. Trong khi ông Allah có phán trong Thiên Kinh Quran, quân lưu lâm sinh ra cho quân máu ích, tất cả mọi sinh vật có linh hồn đều phải đếm đến cái chết. Và trong một chương khác, ông Allah có phán quân lưu lâm sinh ra cho quân máu ích, tất cả mọi sinh vật có linh hồn đều phải đếm đến cái chết. Và trong một chương khác, ông Allah mỗi một linh hồn đều có một thời gian mãn hạn, cái tuổi thọ cuộc sống sẽ chấm dứt, họ sẽ không trì hoãn lại một khoảnh khắc nào và cũng không thể ra đi sớm hơn một giờ khác nào. Cái tên nam sinh viên thân mến, đề tài hôm nay nói về người hàng xóm. Đề tài này rất quan trọng đối với chúng ta và đối với tất cả nhân loại trên toàn thế giới. Nếu ai muốn sống yên ổn, ấm êm trong chính ngôi nhà của chúng ta, thì chúng ta phải nên tìm kiếm và có trong một hai cái khác. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa sallam đã nói: Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa sallam cho biết người tốt nhất là người đối xử tốt với người hàng xóm của mình. خير الأصحاب عند الله تعالى خيرهم لصاحبه وخير الجيران عند الله تعالى خيرهم لجاره. Đối với Allah, người bạn tốt nhất là người tốt với bạn bè của mình, và người hàng xóm tốt nhất đối với Allah là người tốt với người hàng xóm của mình. Cái trên là sự biết thật vậy. Còn có
Taiwan?
Yes, only here.
Alright.
We
to a convenience store, and like you can grab some beer, you can coffee, sit on sidewalk, and you can, you can sing, have a chat, do whatever you want, and have like a barbecue. So lots of people here, they are vendors and they earn money by selling coffee. You know, just like along here, like down there, like this whole area. And like here, you pay only less than $1 for one drink. And you can sit here for like hours, like until, you know, midnight or like whatever you want. And most of the people here, they are young people. You notice, you can see like no elderly people, no foreigners. Because this is like a hidden gem on a boat, on a cruise. And one more thing is that changing color building. So that is the only 6-star hotel that we have in Vietnam. So the name of the hotel is the Times Square. So you can look it up on the internet. It's pretty expensive actually. You pay around $500 for one night there. So that is all about this area.
Okay.
Okay.
So they can earn more money by selling the fruits.
to the citizen people、oh. because in Saigon we cannot grow fruits、
yes.
like either flowers、
mm.
so we most of the fruits here they are imported from the other regions、
mm.
so the people here they are very smart、
yeah.
so they take the boat they come here so they literally they live here、so、they live on the boat so they、go back home once a month to supply the fruit and then they come back here againDelta, while most of the fruit is in the market, they are transporting to the frozen fruit and here also, the market is on the street, so it's more convenient. You pass by, you stop over, and you grab some fruit and you go. You don't have to go to the supermarket.
Flower market.
Oh,
okay.
Down here, there are many steel houses located along the river. So those houses, they have been holding on for much of the day. So they are big to expand their houses. So you can see that those houses are almost falling apart. But actually, the next year, the government is going to demolish all these houses in order to build high buildings like those behind. Because the population here... we're gonna go to Chinatown.
Mm.
So if that area is better than when you shouldn't, you know, expose your phone and your headlight should be in the middle.
Oh, okay.
Because we are doing like a one-on-one tour.
Yes, true.
That is the only thing that you do. So before, these were pink, the color.
Mm.
He decided to repaint the three buildings. So now they are green, the color of bamboo.
Yes.
Because they believe that bamboos, they scare the ghosts away.
Mm.
So that's why he chose the color blue. Mm. I hope this is gonna work. So you can see like on the ground floor,
yes.
there are many restaurants,
yes.
malls.
Mm.
Actually, that is his initial plan.
Mm.
So he is stimulating the people to, you know, he wants to make the people think that like, this area is not that area, you know.
Oh, okay.
Like you can sell, you can like open the restaurants and stuff, so it's safe here.
Mm.
So there's no gold here.
Mm-hmm.
So that's he's step by step. Convincing the people to buy the three buildings. He imported from another area, a city on the mountain called Dalat City. If I heard of it, if you heard of it by chance. It's like a city located on the mountain, so the weather is like cooler.
Mm.
So it's, you know, it's like suitable to grow flowers. Crowded, and it is in the morning.
Mm.
I think probably tomorrow they're gonna take you here, but you don't see like many people like these.
Oh, okay.
Because in the morning they are resting.
Mm.
They do the night shift only.
Thank you. and this is the Cambodian market in the morning. In Saigon, which were built by Americans back in 1968. So you can take pictures first, and I can give you the information.
Okay. So you heard a little bit about the history of Vietnam, right? Like before. The two regions, they were separated.
Yes.
The north and the south. So Americans, they came over here in 1955. So they invaded the south. They said that they came in to help us from communism. But like what they said, they were actually what we didn't really want. So they built these apartments. So one block is like from here to over here. So that is one block. And there are 11 blocks in total here. So one single flat, it's like one flat, it's around 30 to 35 square meters, you know, like that. And because the culture here, we live together intimately. I think pretty much the same in where you're from. So he like generations we live together. So children, parents, and grandparents. So like it's very small, and like around 6 to 8 people living under the same roof. Normally in the morning, daytime, I think they probably gonna take you here tomorrow. You can walk around and see inside the house. You know, like the texture is totally different from the other countries. So you're gonna see because when you compare the flat to the its price, it's like totally like opposite. So the house, the flats and the apartments are getting like older generally, but the price is still very high. It's around 80 like $100,000 for, you know, one flat.
Okay.
So you can rent or like you can buy it. Lots of, you can see like many like scooters here, right? So you have to pay for the security to look after the scooter if you live here. So normally when I come here, I'm gonna park my scooter over there and I'll take you upstairs. But tonight we cannot walk around because it's very late, so we cannot like disturb the people. They are sleeping. So I just like park my scooter over there, but normally you pay 5,000 dong, which is not much, but actually it adds up when you pay yearly. So actually if you live here, you have like a better deal, like you pay monthly, so you have like a discount, so you probably pay less than, you know, like the guests they do. So the flats on the ground floor is like more expensive than the flats on the first floor and the second floor, because can you guess how? Because they can do they can open the parking lot. They can open like a, you know, like fashion shop or like a barber shop. They can do anything that you like, and you can like put your scooters inside without paying for the securities. So that's why it's more expensive, you know, on the ground floor. Therefore, some people, they don't want to spend, you know, money like $5,000 every day because it's not much, but it adds up, like if you pay yearly, it's going to be like a big amount of money. So they figure a way out to drive, to take their scooters up. So they build like a flat stair.
Many
flat stairs like this. I don't think you have it back home.
So they don't drive up because
you drive. Put your scooters inside your. Like, many people are here around here. It's very, it's so much life here in the morning. Now it's like just some people, they still walking, you know, repairing. Back in the 1963, when Americans, they were here, they are Christians, so they wanted to have like an easy control of the South, so they converted like every Buddhist to believe in God like them, so they, you know, converted them to Christians. So this guy, he was a leader of a temple, so he wanted to draw attention of the people by deciding to burn himself to death over there on the corner. He decided to place to build the monument. Actually, he burned himself over there right on that corner, so actually his ashes are kept in like a small temple and shrine. So lots of people, when you come here in the morning, lots of people, they pass, stop over. pray to him. Because if you Buddhist, you definitely believe in him always. And they want to start a day, you know, a new good day. In the morning, lots of people come in to visit him. You know, we can get closer to see his name and his day that he burned. So you can see that there are three roles, right? So the first role, it means God. And the second role, that is his name, so Thất Quảng Đức. So you can Google, you know, Google it later. His story is totally public in on the internet. And the last role is the year that he was born and like, he passed away. You can see like lots of flowers, my donation box. Like incense, so if you want to burn an incense, we can do it. Do you want to burn an incense? No.
You can burn, I watch.
I know, actually I'm agnostic, so I don't really, I respect him, but not really. I don't believe in any certain gods, I believe in science. So when you, one thing is really interesting about Buddhism is that when you burn an incense, you have to make sure that like, you're gonna like, dig it like straight, like, as straight as you can to show your respect to the gods. Like, if you notice, you can see that all of them are very straight. So I have incense, which are donated by the believers. Security guy paid by the government to look after this area. And this is the picture of which portrays exactly what there were many demonstrations. So they stopped all forms of terrorizing and suppressing Buddhists. So before, like when Americans they came over here, they burned lots of temples and they persecuted, they hit many like Buddhists. Because if you refuse to be converted to Christians, you definitely will be like persecuted and stuff. It was really bad. Burning himself on the street. So he was like, surrounded by lots of like Vietnamese monks and like, American soldiers and Vietnamese Southern Vietnamese soldiers as well.
Yeah. you can believe in me.